Fusion Ha!
All right, what's going on, everybody? It's Alan Thomas, aka Shad Assassins, and I have a new Fusion art painting. Today, I painted another Fusion Dragon Ball Z picture. I'm not sure how many of these I've done with a Dragon Ball character at this point, or at least some type of anime character, but today I have a painting of Krillin, Yamcha, and Tien from Dragon Ball Z, and I painted them as the New World Order. So, respectively, I'm not sure what order I just listed them in, but they're Kevin Nash, Scott Hall, and Hulk Hogan. The thought of Krillin being Hulk Hogan is just hysterical to me, and I don't know why. I believe this is the second fusion painting that I've done with Yamcha, and honestly, I think it's the second wrestling-related painting that I've done with Yamcha. Earlier this year, I painted Yamcha as the Heartbreak Kid, Shawn Michaels. So now, I guess, going to WCW with things, I painted him as Scott Hall in this picture, which technically, I guess, would also make my second Scott Hall painting as well. But getting away from that for a second, I wanted to do an NWO style painting, but I didn't want to use the members of the NWO, and I didn't know exactly how I was going to put the characters into this picture. My initial thought process was to paint Nappa, Raditz, and Vegeta is the NWO, but I thought that seemed way too cool to paint as the NWO. Don't get me wrong, the NWO was a cool faction and all, but I felt like this picture needed to be as, I don't want to say uncool, but like, it couldn't have been like tough, badass characters that I painted in this picture to be the NWO. So I knew I was going to put in Krillin and Yamcha. And I guess Tien just had to be the last person. I don't know why, and I think of this now, I should have stuck Hercule in the picture. Honestly, I think I should have replaced Tien with Hercule, only because I feel like Tien is way too cool to be in this picture. Like, Tien is too much of a badass to be in this picture. Even though he got weaker as Dragon Ball Z went on, he's too cool to be here. But, and I actually, the way that I drew Yamcha and Tien in this photo, they actually look so serious. They almost look like bodyguards for Krillin in the manner that I drew them. Like, they're stern faced, no smiles or anything like that. Like, it's almost intimidating. Like, it makes this look not as goofy as I intended for it to initially be, simply because they really do look like badasses standing behind Krillin. Like, I would almost buy Tien and Yamcha as the outsiders. I've been having, now that I think about it, I've been having way too much fun with my last couple paintings. It's like between the Joker painting that I did a couple days ago with Harley Quinn, or this one, it's like these pictures are getting absolutely ridiculous now. But, I mean, they make for the best ones. In terms of like technical aspects of the picture, because I haven't really talked a lot about the drawing of this, there wasn't really too much to talk about. I mean, it's Dragon Ball Z, and they're not in their karate gis. They're in t-shirts and pants, so, I mean, they're dressed like the NWO. What I will say is I almost gave Krillin the sort of pants and t-shirt look that I gave Yamcha and Tien, except I don't know why I wanted to give Krillin the Hollywood Hogan pants. Just randomly towards the end, I decided that I wasn't going to paint Krillin like I did everybody else. Well, I'm not saying towards the end, as I started doing the picture, it's like I'm gonna give him the Hulk Hogan pants. I don't know why, but the airbrush design with the lightning strikes and everything looked cool to me as a kid, so it's like, all right, I guess I'll paint Krillin this way in the picture. As far as the name for the NWO that I was gonna do, I wasn't really sure how I was gonna. I thought about just putting DBZ on their shirts, but I thought that would be almost too plain, and I wasn't gonna actually paint the NWO on it, because I don't know, I just didn't want to. And I thought of the HWO just for the Hermit School, so that's what I rolled with. And as you'll see in the picture, I sort of stopped painting after a while and sort of create like an emblem for the HWO logo that I put on their shirts, and then went ahead and just like copied and pasted on all three characters. I had to adjust it a little bit on Krillin, since Krillin had a more narrower body than the other two. I also almost thought about doing that logo and flipping the H backwards, but I don't know. That might have been a little too much. But like I said, that was pretty much it to the picture. I only need to do like one pass doing shading and highlights, and I really didn't do a lot of highlights. It's just like certain pieces of their clothing and their actual skin I needed to highlight a little bit, and then the case of Krillin and Tien, just put like shade with a little bit of white on like the top of their heads. They're bald, so it's like, okay, a bit of shine to their skulls a bit. But other than that, I didn't really need to do a lot of shading or anything to the picture. So yeah, that's pretty much it. Another goofy fusion painting. I'll probably have more coming up soon. Within the next couple of days, I'll have another Watch Me Draw. Not real sure at the moment what I'm gonna draw, but I'll get around to it. I'll also have some more art related content coming up soon, and I'm gonna have a video because I have a bit of an announcement for something that I'm planning on, or something that I have coming in the works soon that I'll let you all know about. It actually may help some people. I know it's definitely helped me, but I'll get to that later on this week. But in the meantime, I hope you all have a good one, and I hope you like this ridiculous picture. But y'all have a good day. If you haven't already, like and subscribe to my channel. If you're not, leave a comment below, and you all have a good one. I'm out.